Dave Erb here from Dave's Ultimate Automotive in Austin, Texas, and we'll be talking about how to maintain a car at 100,000 miles. Well, 100,000 miles in old times used to be about the point when people thought about getting rid of a car. The way cars are engineered today, that's just not the facts. The cars last much longer, they're designed to last much longer, and they're much better built than they used to be. So at 100,000 miles, it would really depend on if I had any history on the car. How long have I owned the car? What's my maintenance history up to this point? Or did I just buy the car and it has 100,000 miles on it? If I just bought the car and it has 100,000 miles on it, I would do a complete check over on the car, fix any physical aspects, whether it be brakes or torn CV boot or whatever it might be. I'd fix those things and then I'd do a complete maintenance run on it. And that would be all the fluids changed out, the automatic transmission fluid, cooling system flushed. I check the condition of the hoses, replace those if necessary, take a look at the belts, change out the brake fluid, power steering fluid, change the oil, all the fluids, get your a fresh starting point on all those. I'd look at what type of car is it. Does it have a cabin air filter? Has that been checked or changed? Timing belt is a big issue. A lot of manufacturers build cars with timing belts today. And if it has a timing belt, most are due either 60, 90, or 105,000. So if you just bought the car, you know, and it, maybe someone didn't do it at 90 and it's due to be done, or you have no history on it, that's not something you want to let go because that can leave you stranded or cause serious engine damage. So I'd look at it from that standpoint and how long do I want to keep the vehicle. So once again, 100,000 miles, if I had history on the vehicle, I'd rely on that history and then what's due at 100,000, 90 or 105, what has or has not been done, and do those items. If I don't have any history on it, I just bought it, I want to start fresh on everything. Rotate and balance the tires, check the alignment, flush all the fluids, change the oil. If it has a timing belt, get that changed out. And get your stuff to a fresh starting point, so then you can start your oil changes every 3 or 5 after that. You can do your 30,000 mile maintenance, 30,000 from that point. You can rotate your balance and tires and extend the life of those on time as needed. So start yourself on a program, but based on what you know and where you want to go. And that's what I do at 100,000 miles.